Hello, I'm Tom Clausette, and I've got a few tips for you about building a bottle rocket. In this second video in our three-part series, we're going to take a closer look at building fins for your bottle rocket. Before we begin, let's take a look at what you've done so far. In the first video, you wrap strapping tape around your bottle to keep it from expanding and bursting when the bottle is pumped up with air at the launch site. You cut off the retaining ring around the top of the bottle so your finished rocket will fit into the launcher. You decided whether you wanted three or four fins, and you used a door edge to mark horizontal lines on the bottle for fin guides. Now, there are three rules to keep in mind before you begin making fins for your rocket. First, do not build fins that extend below the neck of the bottle. If you do, your rocket simply won't fit on the launcher. Next, fins need to be firmly and rigidly attached to the bottle. If they are not rigidly attached, the fins will wobble back and forth as the rocket launches. This makes for unstable flight. Finally, you want to construct rocket fins from stiff, lightweight, non-flexible, and waterproof material. If you use fins that are too thin and flimsy, the force of air rushing over the fins at launch will distort their shape and cause the rocket to fly off course, or worse, tumble off the launcher and not go anywhere. These three bottle rockets have fins that are made from thin, flimsy paper. The fins are just not stiff enough to stabilize the rocket in flight. So this idea of having lightweight, stiff, and waterproof fin material and attaching the fins rigidly to the bottle is very important. Now let's consider placement of the fins on the bottle. The further toward the rear fins are placed, the more effective they are. Small fins far back may be as effective as larger fins further forward, and smaller fins produce less wind resistance or drag. To get the right materials, we're going to go shopping for a few supplies. You already have strapping tape, but we need material for the fins themselves. There are several websites that show directions for creating fins out of note card stock or poster board paper, but I found that these tend to get damaged too easily. Once a paper fin is bent or crimped in the wrong place, the only way to fix it is to replace the fin. I like a set of fins that will hold up and last, even when they are bumped or mishandled. My favorite material for bottle rocket fins is plastic two-pocket folders from Office Depot. One folder is all you need to make four fins. Here are several basic fin shapes. Notice that each design has one flat side that will attach to the bottle. Right, let's get started. Take a piece of blank printer paper, fold it in half from top to bottom. Use a ruler to lay out a triangular shape. Here is a guide showing measurements for a basic fin. I'll leave this picture on the screen for a bit so that you can copy down the numbers for reference. Now, once you've traced around this, cut out the shape you've drawn and crease along the fold lines. Before you go any further, hold your paper fin against your bottle to test for size. If it is too big or too small, start over with a fresh piece of printer paper. You could even try out a stylized fin shape if you wanted. Let's assume you like the triangular shape just fine and you're ready to use the template to cut out three or four fins. Trace around the edges of your paper design with a permanent marker and then cut out the fin shapes with a pair of scissors. To keep the sides of the fins stuck together, I use contact cement. Be careful of the fumes, though. Use strapping tape to attach each fin to the bottle. Now you're ready to begin working on the nose cone. But I'm going to stop here. You've made excellent progress. Check out bottle rocket video number 3 to learn how to balance your bottle rocket, adjust its weight, and build a nose cone.